Greetings, adventurers. Welcome back to another episode of Betrayer. Well, I'm going to continue where I left off, and currently I'm here in Fort Henry with our lovely lady in red there, but I'm about to ring the bell and go back into the spirit world. Then I'll take a look around and see. Whoa. I'll see if there's some other things I may have missed along some paths. So, I'm gonna go down this way this time and see what we can see. Now I hear a chiming sound. Oh, there's a chest. 31 coins. I will take that. Thank you. Whoa, I just heard something. I heard something. Uh-oh, it looks like another corrupted totem. And it could be some, spirits around, some bad spirits, like last time. Probably. Whoa! Corruption is gone? How did that happen? Now, I thought I heard like a skeleton popping out of somewhere, but I didn't see it. Okay, well, I'll take it. All I had to do was walk near it this time. I will take that, and I'm a bit paranoid here. I'll keep looking around a little bit more in the spirit world. Let's see, where am I at the map? Oh, I'm over here. Okay. Well, let's keep going this away. Where is that? Right. Okay. Now I don't know if clearing the corruption on that totem we just cleared will have opened the south gate. Everything looks so different in the spirit world, and there's no breeze. Oh, there's another grave here. Let's take a look. This grave is unmarked. Okay. I think I see something ahead. Something glowing or glimmering. What is that? Another chest or... Whoa. Okay, there's a pile. I can dig with the trowel. Dug up a valuable looking distinctive necklace of gold and topaz. Okay. And it looks like there's some bones in some rocks. Maybe it used to be a grave? Let's take a look. Among the stones you find the remains of a woman. Strands of long dark hair are still attached to the moldering skull. There's a bullet hole in the forehead. Well, I don't know if that's good or bad. Probably bad. let's take a look at my map now. Oh, okay, if I keep going that way, I'm almost at the south gate again. But, oh, ahead I think I see another corrupt totem, so I have to be careful because sometimes enemies pop out when I get near them. Oh, I hear screaming this time. So that means something bad. Where are they? Oh, there's one. They're kind of fast. Okay, I got one. Oh, there's three of them. Uh-oh. A bit hurt. I took him out with my knife. But, I got a bit hurt on that one, because he was hitting me back. Woo! Wow, they're scary. The wind has shifted, dispersing the stench. Okay, I couldn't read it all before it disappeared. I was busy looking around. But, it has been cleansed of corruption. Okay, so maybe... maybe that was the last totem that I had to clear. Where am I? Here. I must be close to the south gate by the looks of the map. So maybe that cleared the corruption that was on the gate, but I still have to be very cautious because there could be enemies lurking about. Okay, yes, there's the south gate ahead. And, now there's that pile of rocks I can't dig up till I find a shovel or something. And hey, guess what? It looks like the corruption is gone, but, I don't think there's a way I can open it in the spirit world. I probably have to return to... the normal world. So I'm gonna jump back to the map and fast travel to Fort Henry, and then let us ring the bell to return to the well, actually I'm gonna talk to Edmund first. Or this is William, this one's William. Yeah, do you recognize this topaz necklace? It is Martha's. I gave it to her after our son was born. So I say, I found it near the remains of a woman who had been shot. And William says, now I remember. I found her on a hillside to the south on a warm and pleasant morning. I sat beside her, holding her hand and talking about her son as she died. Well, that sucks. It was you who buried her? He says, yes, I thought she would rest better than there than near the fort. So I covered her over with stones. I meant to return to dig her a proper grave, but someone stole our only spade, and a trowel would not suffice. Aha, so he's maybe going to tell me about a spade, which is a type of shovel. Okay, well, you didn't tell me where it was. No, he doesn't say anything more than that. Well, let's go talk to our other spirit friend first. And, now this one's Gregory, okay? And, if I recall, I'm just trying to remember the names. I think the name of his lost friend was Edmund. That's right. So he's Gregory. I think I'm looking for Edmund, his lost friend. Let's return to the, normal world. Whew, that always, startles me a little bit. And, we'll go talk to our lovely maiden in red and see if she has anything new to say. Are you finding lots of battles? I'm sure they're exciting and perilous. Well... yes, I'm finding some battles, but they're also dangerous. So, yeah, for a second that shadow, I was wondering what that shadow was. It looks like it's from that church here. And it looks like the door's locked. There's no way to get in. Well, what I'm going to do is... I'm just going to stock up on a few supplies at the store here, and then I will return to the the south gate. Okay, so I topped off my supply of arrows and had a drink of water. And I'm ready to return to the south gate, I believe. I might as well speed travel there, fast travel there. Hopefully no enemies are lurking about. Aha, look at that. In the normal world, the south gate is open. So, clearing the corruption on those totem markers apparently apparently opened the south gate. But when I was still in the spirit world, I wasn't able to go through because the gate was still closed while I was in the spirit world. Okay, so we're in a new section of this island or whatever we're on. Let me look at the map here. Okay, so that's called the East Road. So this is a new map. Whoa. That sounded like a starling or something. Some kind of squawky bird. Yeah, I really, really like the ambience of this game. How the breeze blows through the trees and grass and the sounds of the wind and the birds. And so that's where we came from. Now if I walk back that way, I'd probably get back to the south gate, but I guess from here we shall move forward. And I got to be on guard because there could be enemies lurking about. I'm sort of like staying on the edge near the bushes. Check out this crate here. And it looks like it's empty, that one. I see some glittering. I think it's a note. Well, let's pick it up. Let's see. It says, "The Warance grew frantic when he realized where Captain Harper proposed to lead his expedition, saying, 'We must never venture into that force, lest we disturb the evil that slumbers there.' The captain tried to offer reassurance that we would tread lightly, but the Warance rose up in wrath and swore to leave none of us alive should we defy him in this matter." Now, that doesn't sound very nice. Now, if I remember, Warance was like the king or the leader of the naturals, or the natives. Now, here's a grave marker here. Mary Shortridge, age 28, succumbed to sickness. And I see something up here. It's another little lookout spot. Whoa, and there are enemies. Yeah, I see there's an enemy up the path. I don't think he's seen me yet. I think I see one up that direction that I'm pointing my arrow now, but he's way too far for me to hit now. Oh, and there's two enemies on this path. Oh. So, looks like I'm going to have my hands full. So, I think I'm going to hide in this bush. hide! And see if I can, see if there's some kind of pattern that they take. And maybe I can sneak from bush to bush. Oh great, now I got a log kind of trapping me. Now I'm staying crouch in the grass here, and then, I think he's seen me. Yeah, he's seen me. He dodged my arrow. Okay, I got one. Well, let's gather up some arrows. I lost a couple arrows shooting at them. Oh boy. Well, that's one down, and there's a couple more to go. Let us, I was trying to be stealthy, but I guess I didn't have much cover where I was. So I'm going to run up to this bush and try to be stealthy again. And see if I can get a good shot on the next one from our little hiding spot. I don't know if I can get a headshot on him, but I can try. Oh, I overshot. Damn. It's harder to get a headshot than it looks. Okay, I got him. But I wasted a few arrows. Actually, I didn't mean to shoot that last arrow, but it happened. Now I hear some growling, so there's another enemy nearby. But I wanted to get my arrows. Oh, is that a big one? Is that one of the big ones? No, that's a normal size one. Let's see if I can get a headshot. Alright, he has a bow. Okay, I got him. I'm getting low in arrows, though. Whew. Oh, there's another one. He's got a musket, that one. Can I get him? Headshot, come on. I overshot him, but he missed me. Maybe I'm a little out of his range. Come on. Okay, whew. That was kind of scary. Oh, crap. I didn't even see him there. Oh, boy. Now, it looks like I unlocked a new camp or location. Let's get some goodies here. Collect my arrows. Oh, he's like a pincushion, that guy. Yeah, I hit him a few times, this one. But my arrows are full now. And there's more of these ash figures. Something bad happened to the people that lived here. Let me pick up this note. With Benedict Harper's expedition party now long overdue and presumed killed by savage treachery, the council has chosen to make James Markley's conditional governorship permanent. The council asks that you show him all respect and courtesy due the Lord Governor of this colony. Now I'm going to check my map real quick. And we are at the Hilltop Camp, apparently. Okay. So this is the new area that we unlocked. And what is this? Okay, it's probably another arrow. It says I can't carry it. Another one of these ash figures. Yeah, something bad happened to the people here. They got turned into those ash figures by some evil force somehow. Another crate. And can't carry. I'm full. Water. I will drink that water. I hear some chiming sound somewhere. Where is that chiming sound? Probably a chest or something in the... Oh, another note. Well, let's read this note. This morning, we observed two savages observing us from the adjacent hill for more than 2 hours. They made no effort to conceal themselves and seemed very relaxed and curious. Samuel Mullard remarked that if we could see two of them, then there must be another dozen hidden. Samuel Mullard, I think that's one of the names I seen in one of the graves before, if I recall. I don't know, there's so many names swimming around in my head, I can't remember them all right now. Well, I think we made some good progress this episode, and I think I will save my progress here, and finish this episode. I don't see anything else immediately in the general vicinity. I can hear some birds squawking somewhere and some animal sounds in the wind. And it looks down the path there's some kind of structure, like another lookout hut there. So maybe it's another little encampment. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching. I'll be back.